Hi, everybody. It's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today, I'm going to talk about the shocking truth about erectile dysfunction statistics. Now, listen, one of the biggest things that can cause a man to not feel like a man is having erectile problems. Sure, guys joke about penis size all the time, and of course, their confidence goes up if they have, you know, a bigger penis. But even the guy with the biggest penis doesn't feel like a man if he can't get an erection, right? But before I talk about the shocking statistics about guys and ED, let me first give you the true definition of it. Erectile dysfunction is the inability to develop or maintain an erection for satisfactory sexual intercourse. Also, erectile dysfunction is a preferred term rather than impotence. Now, if you do have ED problems once in a while, that's normal, all right? It happens to all men, even though most guys will not admit to it. However, if it's been going on and off for more than a couple of months, then we can assume you do have some degree of erectile dysfunction, which is a warning sign of a health problem. All right, so let's talk about the statistics. When you think about ED, you typically picture, you know, an older guy in his 60s or 70s. Well, not that you're thinking about guys in their 70s, just that it tends to happen to older men. However, ED problems are starting in guys in their mid-20s. In fact, statistics show that 20% of men in their 20s have ED, 40% of guys in their 40s, 60% of men in their 60s, so on and so forth. Now, the prevalence of complete ED increases from 10% to 15% as age increases from 40 to 70 years old. Thus, even though it does affect men to some degree at all ages, after the age of 40 is when the real problems become common. In fact, this is called andropause in men, similar to menopause in women. And the cause is similar to most everyone. It's basically a negative change in your hormones, primarily due to aging. This is due to an imbalance in your hormones, basically. A decrease in your pro-sexual hormones, such as total and free testosterone, versus an increase in your negative, what I call anti-sexual hormones, such as female hormones, estrogens, progesterones, prolactin, and also stress hormones, cortisol, and adrenaline. All right, so what causes ED? Unfortunately, your penis has a mind of its own, right? And thus, there can be a lot of causes leading to ED. Different medications and drugs can cause ED. Stress and worry, vascular and blood flow, boredom with your partner, fatigue, illness, and of course, the negative change in your hormones due to aging. So what are the solutions? Basically, the solution has to be based on the original problem. For example, people who have heart disease or diabetes have vascular and blood flow problems, leading to erectile dysfunction. In this situation, you need to improve your lifestyle, eat better, exercise, and take the right supplements to help fix this problem and prevent it from getting worse. However, over and over again, the common denominator tends to be hormonal. Listen, stress, worry, anxiety, depression can all cause ED. Now, some experts will say, hey, that's not hormonal, that's an emotional problem. Yes, to some degree, all right, but I still say no. Listen, stress and worry causes an increase in your fight or flight stress hormones such as adrenaline and cortisol, both opposing testosterone and lowering this primary sex drive hormone. Or people who are overweight and have extra belly fat, they have higher estrogen levels because fat cells actually produce estrogen, which will send a signal to your testicles to produce less testosterone, turning your testicles off. Now you end up with a higher ratio of female hormones to male hormones, which is obviously bad for getting an erection. By the way, more female hormones caused, you know, depression and anxiety, which now goes right back to the beginning, causing more stress and thus less testosterone. This turns into this big negative loop, causing more and more hormonal problems. This is why the older you get, the lower your testosterone and the more ED problems, thus andropause. What you need to do is fix your hormones and you'll fix your ED. You'll improve your drive both in the bedroom and in life. Now, today's video is about ED statistics and thus I don't have enough time to talk about how to optimize your libido hormones. However, below this video in the description area, you can click on a private link which will give you more details about this topic and natural ways of increasing your testosterone and improving your hormones to help fix ED. Just remember that the older you get, the worse this problem becomes. So please make sure you take action today to fix the situation before it gets worse. Well, that's it for today. You know, I hope this video gave you more clarity. If you liked it, please subscribe to this channel because I've got some really cool exclusive videos coming out soon. If you found it helpful, please share the health with others so they can benefit as well. Also, do me a favor and please leave your comments below and any questions you may have about today's topic or future ones. And most importantly, do yourself a big favor and make sure you click the link in the description box below for natural ways of increasing your testosterone, boosting your sex drive, and preventing erectile dysfunction. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.